What's up and welcome to another episode. Today is going to be really fun. I'm talking new dive gear and a new dive site. Before we get into the dive, I just want to talk for a couple of minutes on the gear I got and why I got it. So in the last episode, I was talking about my gauge that was kind of hanging off to the side, and it's kind of bad etiquette to do that.
See how my gauge right here is dragging low?
No, we want to get that streamlined and fix that, and I ordered a dive computer and a couple other things to make that happen. So, first things first, dive computer. I decided to get the Atmos Mission 1 dive computer because it's small, it fits on my wrists, it helps with hose management, and it looks like a normal watch. It's not that expensive, and it looks like a normal watch, so I could wear it daily, and it covers scuba diving and free diving and everything that I would need. Next are these two little guys. They're 70 degree angle, like hose connectors. I got them from divegearexpress.com. They came really fast, they're pretty cheap, and those are gonna help my regulator hoses. Instead of going way out to the side over here and around my shoulder, they're actually gonna change direction, go underneath my armpit, and they're gonna stay more tight to my body and close. Last but not least, I got this analog pressure gauge, also from Dive Gear Express. It's gonna show me my tank pressure whenever I need it. I don't get to see my tank pressure on my watch because it doesn't have a wireless transmitter. Some do, but they're way more expensive. So I went with a cheaper option. It's gonna work perfectly, and it's gonna help me be more streamlined. So now, all we gotta do is hook it all up. I just bought a new way. Spend a couple thousand just to cruise it. Shawty said she love me, but it's fresh enough to prove it. You should probably always get this done by a professional, or if you do it yourself, get it checked by a professional after, because these are, you know, high pressure and low pressure seals, and they're kind of a life support system, so you want to make sure it's working good. I had like an extra, like this cable here, it was like kind of dangling all over the place, so I just tied it together like this, try to streamline this area a little bit. There was kind of stuff going all over when I watched the clips back from the last video. Had things going all over the place. First thing we're gonna do is we're gonna change this connection here. Instead of coming out straight, we're gonna put one of the 70 degree angles in here so it comes down this way and underneath my armpit. First one's done, super fast, super simple. Has a little bit of a swivel action to it. It's just gonna be a lot better overall for the system. I have two of them, and this is my backup regulator. Just in case I have a problem with my full face mask, I can switch to my other regulator and be all right. I also bring an extra mask with me in one of my pockets, my BCD. So I've just got a full backup system. You can tell my little mouthpiece is having some issues. Gonna need to replace that. Alright, second one's done. That'll keep this hose nice and out of the way. Change the angle a little bit, keep it tighter to my body. That's the backup rig. Next, we're gonna replace my gauge computer combo with this analog gauge. Alright, now the analog gauge is on. And last but not least, we wanna tie on a little cable like slash hose management piece here. I have like a little extension. Now that that's tied on there, pretty standard bolt snap knot. I'm gonna have to tighten this really hard and then get a lighter and burn these strings down so that they melt into each other so they don't come off. I'm just gonna plug it into a tank now and make sure nothing's leaking and make sure the gauge is working. We should be good. The moment of truth. Nothing's leaking. Is it reading? Oh yeah, almost 3000 PSI, which is almost a full tank, pretty much a full tank. I don't hear any leaks anywhere. The rig is loaded. We got all the dive gear we could ever need. We got Jackson, who's bringing his epic water housing to get some epic shots.
It's gonna be freaking epic with a capital E, dude!
Hopefully we see some wildlife and some craziness. And we're even gonna do a little time lapse.
Oh, yeah! GoPro time lapse, baby! Thank you.
took a vow in summertime. Now we find ourselves.
Oh, we have made it to Electric Beach.
Oh, look at all the crabs. Crabs, 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 crabs. And the stonewalls finally all
bear witness. Anybody with the drone master himself.
Hello!
Did you bring the little beast? That thing is so sick. I think we're gonna get some sick shots. I'm not sure what we're gonna do. I don't think it's very legal to fly around that.
It took us a minute to get here and get all geared up. Scuba gear takes forever to put together, but everybody's here. Gavin's here with the drone. Jax is here with his sick GH5 underwater crazy cinematic footage. So that's awesome. So we'll be able to put together a really cool segment. It's time to go dive, finally. All right, I'm ready now, I ain't gonna fall back now. All right, I'm take it on me, baby. All right, I ever ask, you gonna be my brother. Tonight, I take it with me.
If I left, then it made no sense. I had to reroute some cables and some hoses and stuff, but it's working good now. I still have a slight restriction looking left because of my cables on this side, so I may have to look into maybe getting a longer hose or rerouting some things. This one's unique because it has two really big pipes that are shooting warm water out from the electric plant across the street. So for that reason, it attracts a lot of fish. There's a lot of reef growing on the rocks and things over the pipe. It's made like a cool little natural environment, and a lot of wildlife come around here. Jackson's off chasing the dolphins. Hopefully he finds them. That'd be pretty cool. So we're at 19 feet right now. We've been underwater for 11 minutes and 23 seconds. The water temperature is 79 degrees Fahrenheit, and we're heading at a heading of 222 degrees. I've routed the gauge hose right over my shoulder here, and it's got the extension, which is pretty convenient. We've got 2200 PSI right now, so we've got plenty of air to go have some fun. And as we go out, the water is just gonna get clearer and clearer. This is kind of where the pipes now come up at an angle, out from underground. Basically covering that, or coming at the same angle as that piece of metal there. And this has created an artificial reef, all kinds of different reef formations on here now. And right at the end here, you'll see this huge pipe shooting out all this water. It actually creates this current at the top. It's like kind of an artificial man-made rip current. It pushes you straight out to sea, so if you come here, be careful. If you get in that current, it will push you pretty far. But to get out of a rip current, all you gotta do is swim parallel to the beach, and you'll be out of it in no time. Alright, coming around the corner. We've got a really big sea turtle here. And here are the two entrances to the pipes, or the exits rather. All shooting tons and tons of water out. You can see all the fish swimming in the current. Right over here, we've got a turtle, so we'll go say hi to him. Remember, you're not allowed to touch them, but they don't mind you getting pretty close, so we'll go say hi to this guy. He's big. Left and right, they're calling me back home. And I've heard their cries, I felt it in my bones. You can see the flag getting pulled behind me. If you're wondering what the hazards of Electric Beach are when you come diving here, this is definitely one of them. You can hook up your flag to, you can tie it off to some rocks or a different structure. Or if you have a sand screw, you can put it in the sand. That way it stays out of the current. But here's a little structure here. I'm not sure what this used to be. Maybe an old little light tower or something. Or we can tie off our buoy to this, a little dive flag. that, just for good measure. Let's go see what we can, what's going on over here by the pipes. There's a fair amount of surge in the water. You can feel it, like, see, we're going this way. It'll probably surge back this way if you're really careful. See, the current's right here, but if you stay low enough, you won't get caught by it. And you can scoot right through. Whoa, 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 whoa. It's okay if it takes you for a ride, but it also pushes you up to the surface pretty fast, and you gotta be ready for that. And if you're not, it could potentially be dangerous. I believe it's a type of nudibranch. I could be wrong though. Trying to hang on and not fly away. Oh, what's this thing? What the heck is that? Oh, here's another one. Look, I got two of them. Whoa, look at this squirrel. Something is big and healthy. Now I'm cruising on the other side of the pipes, and there's whole walls here, different types of coral. I'll give you a little close up here. All kinds of stuff going on, it's pretty cool. Every time I end a dime, I always wish it was longer. I need to work on my two tank or side mount certification so I can go longer. And then eventually get a rebreather and I can go for a really long time. Thanks for joining me on the channel, checking out the gear, checking out the dives, checking out everything we're doing. Again, hopefully there's more waves coming to the North Shore and we'll be able to get out there and make some videos about surfing. Hello, Gavin. Hello. Seriously feel like I'm in a spacesuit. Like I could just roll up to the moon and have no worries.
I was like freaking out on the sideline the whole time, just seeing all these little dolphins jumping like crazy. And I was trying to keep my cool, but it was hard to do. And then I'm like, okay, I'll wait for everybody. And then the second we touched the water, I just beelined it out there. And I got the shot, dude.
That's cool you scored. There was no way I was keeping up with you with all that gear.
Yeah, dude, I'm too quick out there.
How'd the drone shots go? Got some good ones?
I think I got some good ones.
Some bangers?
I almost flew straight into the cliff. At one point, I was buzzing your head, and I thought I was going to go in the drink, dude. I'm right. So close.
Like right before we dove? Like as we were swimming out?
Yeah.
Yeah, I saw you. It was crazy. And then all of a sudden, you like shot straight up.
Yeah, because I was like, maybe I should be further away from the water.
And then I let you try the full face mask at the end. What did you think of that?
Oh my gosh, dude. It was so insane. Seriously, it feels like I'm a spaceman.
Well, that was a super fun day, hanging out with everybody, going for a dive. We just enjoyed sunset on the back deck, and Gavin flew his drone again. Got some epic shots. I'll roll on those after this, but Thanks for coming out and hanging out in the videos. Thanks for watching. Always a good time.
Thanks for the drone shots, bro.
Woo, yeah.
So sick. You're getting freaking good at that thing, dude.
Thanks, dude. I'm scared the whole time.
You're scared the whole time?
I'm scared always.
That thing looks really scary to learn and fly, but I'm going to get the simulator and start learning it. But that's it for me today. See you guys next time. When they say they doing all this and all that. Tired of beefing you bums, you can't even pay me enough to react. Been waking up in the crib, and sometimes I don't even know where I'm at. Please don't pay that nigga songs in this party, I can't even listen to that. Anytime that I run into somebody, it must be a victory lap, ayy. Shawty, come sit on my lap.